Dear friends, I am Parvinder from West Highlander and I welcome you all in this video about New Zealand study visa, in which I will be speaking about one of the queries we receive from study in New Zealand applicants. The applicants are interested to know, is study gap acceptable for New Zealand study visa? To address this query, I would firstly be speaking about what exactly constitutes a gap and what is not a gap. After that, I would be giving certain examples under which circumstances the students may apply for the New Zealand study visa with gap. So friends, keep watching for complete information. There is no specific yes or no for the question whether you can apply for your New Zealand study visa with a gap. To understand this, first the applicants need to know what exactly would be a gap and what would not be a gap. So, it would depend on your circumstances whether you could file your application with a study gap or not. Let's say that you are an applicant who did your last qualification about 2 years back. After that last qualification, you have not been involved in any activity which could add on to your career or your future study goals. You were not doing anything. Now, this is a pure gap. If you have this kind of gap, then it could cause problems with your application, and the answer for the question that can you apply for your New Zealand study visa with gap would be no. But if you are an applicant who did your qualification, let's say 2 years back, and after that were involved in some activity which was adding on to your career goals or your future academic pathway, then these are the circumstances that you were involved in some activity. Applicants must take care that if they have got this kind of activity, then they must have a verifiable evidence accepted by Immigration New Zealand to provide that you were involved in certain kind of activity. Now, this would not exactly constitute a gap, as there was some things you were doing. So it totally depends on the circumstances of the applicant. Here I would like to quote some examples to make it more clear what is a gap and what may not be counted as a gap. Let's say that you are a student who did your bachelor's 2 years back, and after that you were involved in some work experience. Now, this may be a study gap, but you have got work experience, so this is not a gap. Applicants can apply for the New Zealand study visa with documents showing that they were involved in work experience. Another example could be of an applicant who did graduation, let's say 2 years back, and after that was involved in preparation of some exams so that he could join some course here in India, or those exams could be related to some government positions or some competitive exams. Now, in this case, no doubt, you were not academically involved in some activity, but you were involved in an activity which you were looking further in terms of your career or academic pathway. This would not be a gap, and the students can apply for the New Zealand study visa with evidence that they were involved in this kind of activity. Another example could be of a student who did his or her 10 plus 2 2 years back, and after that applied for study in Canada visa application twice. But unfortunately, the application got refused. Now, technically, there is a study gap, but you were involved in an activity to study further in Canada. The students can attach the proofs of these activities along with their application, which would justify that 2 years period. Another example could be of a student who did his qualification 2 years back, but due to certain personal circumstances, unavoidable personal circumstances, that could be some problem in the family, of course, for which you must have evidence. That could be a medical issue which required you to take that gap. If you have these kind of evidence, then also you may apply for your New Zealand study visa. Applicants must take care that these circumstances are individual. So not all circumstances would fit the profile of all the applicants. So the applicants need to discuss in detail with their educational consultant before taking decision to apply for their New Zealand study visa. Friends, I hope you find this video useful. For any query you may have about your study in New Zealand, please contact West Highlander. We are a team of experienced and expert counselors who can help you throughout the process. Thank you.